So, Inkbird sent me their ITC-308 dual relay temperature controller to play with. Nice, thank you so much. This is a sponsor video. So, if you have a problem with that, click off or think of this like a commercial. But no, I wouldn't like try to push product I don't believe in on you. I have been using one of these for years actually. If the doctor could like fill in some B-roll, yeah, you can see that I actually have one of these sitting on my keyser in my brew shed. So I know what they are putting out, some good products. But thank you Inkbird for sponsoring this video. So we're gonna check this one out, what you get in the package and how to use it. Yeah, let's kick it. I'm Dr. Hans, this is Dr. Hans Brewery, my channel about beer and homebrewing. Unboxing video sucks. Let's try to make this cool. So here we have the product in all its glory. And of course, depending on where you live in the world, you will get this with different plugs. But I'm from Sweden, so this is the European version, but you will of course have the US version, the British version, and the Australian version as well. So we're getting a 1.5 meters, and yes, the doctor will convert everything into birds and stones. Thank you. And we have a 2 meter long probe cord. So dual relay temperature controller, what does that mean? A relay turns on and off power. So this controller puts power on and off in these two jacks here. And we have cooling and we are heating. And you can use these for a lot of things, not just homebrewing. For homebrewers, it might be like a controller fermentation fridge, where you put one in the cooling, where you put the cooling here into the fridge. And for the heating, you have some sort of heat element. I most often use like heating mats built for like terrariums and planting seeds and so on. You don't have to use both. For my keyser, I'm actually using just one for the cooling because I don't ferment it. If you just look at the design, we have this dual outlet block here with the cooling and heating hanging from the base unit. But as this is wall mounted, both of them, you can actually mount this as some sort of a panel. So that's cool. One awesome thing about this product, now in this modern day and age, when we use like our smartphone for everything, this does not have an app. This is amazing. I bought this speaker this summer to have in my garden and doesn't have an app also. It's amazing, it just works. There I have a version also, a Wi-Fi version with an app, or of course benefits of that, but the simplicity to not need an app. This is more like a plug and play unit. We have only three buttons here. We have a set button and we have one up and down button. We have two screens on there. We have the desired temperature and we have the actual temperature. Two lights here. We have one from heating and one from cooling. When this unit is in heating mode, we will get a red light here. This is a cooling mode. It's like a yellowish green light. That is my biggest beef with the product. Why, Inkbird, isn't it blue? If you're ever making an updated version of this, the cooling should be blue. This is super simple to operate, and you of course get a manual with this. You probably would not read it, but I would suggest that you would. And all of the readings in this is of course available both in Celsius and Fahrenheit. You just have to set it up in the controller head here. And this is more or less like a set it and forget it. Besides that it would turn on cooling and heating to try to ride that temperature, it also has an alarm. So you can set up, let's say I have it set up on my keyser there. If something really goes bad, I don't want my kegs to freeze. I could set it up too. If it reaches like a 0.5 Celsius degrees, it will have an internal buzzer here. So it will start to scream. Or on the opposite, if I don't want hot beers, I could set it up to like, if my beer goes over like 15 degrees Celsius, please start to scream. And everything of this can be set in the box. You can always read here on the front with these panels what your actual temperature are and what your desired temperature are. And if you press the up or down button, you can see how much waving room you have allowed. And from the factory, it's set to 2 degrees Celsius. I think that is a little bit much. That means that it will swing quite a lot. So if I set this to ferment at 20 degrees and I've set it to 2, and you can set the chilling swing and the heating swing differently if you want to. But it means, if I set it to 20, it means that this will actually drop down to 17.9 Celsius before it starts to heat up. And it will heat up until it goes to 22.1. So I would recommend you just lower that, so it will more or less stay around that desired temperature. This also has a really important feature, which is a compressor delay time, which means that it won't turn on the relay as soon as you hit the temperature. It will wait a bit. So if you had set this up to a fridge that normally has a compressor, it will not turn off. It will go to more of a slow pace. Otherwise, you will burn out your fridge. And for me, also something that I have been enjoying about the Inkbird product. Some products don't do this. My STC-1000 have no problem with this, but I have seen some other products that don't really work this way. If you have a power shortage and the power comes back, this will just work. There's no problem at all. I have never had an issue. And the last storm was actually named after me. And of course, I had a power outage, but there were no problems with my Inkbird fridge. There was no problem with my STC-1000 either, but it is important. I've linked down to all the specs for this unit. According to Inkbird, this has an accuracy of plus minus 1 Celsius degree or plus minus 2 degrees Fahrenheit. And this can be set in 0.1 Celsius degrees increment. Yes, it's hard with the words and stones and Celsius, but I hope I'm rocking it or the doctor will fix it in post. I had to agree with Inkbird that this is like a plug and play thermostat. Says here on the back. I've never had any issues with mine at all, and I would highly recommend it, even though this is a sponsor widget. Let's have a look how to operate this. Should we read the manual? Probably not. This temperature control range is from minus 50 to 120 degrees Celsius or minus 58 Fahrenheit to 248 Fahrenheit. So you could use this for fermentation. You could also use for like a boiling brewing system also. So we have the top screen here where we can see our actual temperature, what the probe is reading. And on the bottom screen here, we can see our desired temperature. So this is set to 16.9 degrees Celsius, and that's lower than the actual temperature. So you can see that the unit is cooling. That means that we are getting power to this cooling jack here. Simple. And if I do press the up arrow, I can see how much I allow for the temperature to fluctuate. And this is from factory settings to 2 degrees Celsius. I will change that out. And the same on the bottom side. This is now set up to go 2 degrees under the desired temperature. I think this is quite a lot, so we will change that out. To get into programming mode, we will push the set button for like 3 seconds. And here we will set our desired temperature fermentation. So I'm thinking, let's set this into some sort of ale. 20 degrees Celsius. Okay, we press set again. And now we can see that we're getting the HD. The doctor, can you like put some sort of text here to explain everything from the manual? I don't want to fluctuate that much. So I will lower this to like, am I screaming? Sorry for that. 0.3, that's good enough. Okay. No problems, that's it. And I will do the same on the heat side. Set it to 0.3. Totally overkill anal enough. That would be good. Then by pressing set, we go to the next settings. And this is the alarm for high heat. This is at 120 degrees Celsius. That's a little bit high for me. I'm thinking I want to know if this goes over, let's say 25 degrees Celsius. That means that if for some reason this goes over 25 degrees Celsius, this thing will start to buzz. Is this good content? Meanwhile, this is pushing. Let me just warn you that please do not subscribe to my channel. My channel suck. And you will only encourage me and sponsors like Inkbird today to further drive this madness. But I do appreciate a nasty comment and a thumbs up. And we also have the alarm for the low side also. I'm setting this up for fermentation now. If I would set up this for a fridge or anything, I would of course not use these temperatures. You have to think for yourself. But I'm thinking, I want to know what this drops, maybe in this case, down below 18 degrees Celsius, maybe. If I would set it up for a kegerator or keiser, I would like monitor it differently, of course, than fermentation. And if I were to set this up for a brewing system, I would also, of course, set it up differently. You can do whatever you want, and it's really, really easy. If something would happen to my heating mat now and my fermentation temperature would drop under 18 degrees Celsius, this would start beeping and set. And the PT is the compressor delay. I'm thinking this is in minutes, so I'm setting this to like 3 minutes. I don't want my fridge to instantly turn on and off. Yes, on and on again. I don't want to ruin my compressor. So this gives that lag time for 3 minutes. Like if you were opening your door and you wouldn't have perfect insulation of your probe, your fridge doesn't just kick in. And the next one, the CA, is for calibrating your probe if you found it not to be as accurate. I never had any problem with that, but it's good, you can set it in here. And the last one is, of course, Celsius and Fahrenheit. You can change it, but I'm gonna keep mine in Celsius. To get out of the menu, just wait or push the button for 3 seconds. Most stuff you don't need to change every time, and I'll set my alarm now quite close to that desired temperature. If you just put them at a much wider range, you don't need to like set everything each time. And it's really simple to do things during fermentation if you want to ramp up the temperature, but you have to do it step by step. There's no programming here at all. This is actually, even though my STC-1000 is programmable, I'm just doing it manually. But we're all different, and there are different products for different kind of people. I do prefer this like simple products, but I'm all up for it if you want me to give the Wi-Fi version a short. Big shout out to my Patreon and channel members. I will do a separate video for you after this. Let me know if you have any like questions on this unit, or if you have used it, what you think about it. Let Inkbird know down in the comments if you want me to try out their Wi-Fi version. Thank you, Inkbird, for sponsoring the video. If you haven't built a kegerator yet, why don't you check out when I build mine? This video, nice. Dog is sleeping, Dr. Hans out. Cheers.
Du behöver ju en där du sover också, Stig. Jag sa att du sover.